straight out to Nicole Parton, investigative reporter. Nicole, what happened?
The 16-year-old mother, Michaela King, leaves her 5-month-old baby around 2 o'clock on Saturday to do some shopping with this would-be 17-year-old babysitter, whom we have learned has been living in the home for the past couple of months. When the mother returns home from the shopping spree, she finds no baby, no babysitter. We've also learned that the babysitter has no cell phone. She has no car. The only thing she has at this point is the baby, a stroller, and a diaper bag.
To Clark Golban, also on the story. Clark, what more can you tell us?
Well, Nancy, there's some late-breaking information that we've just gotten in a few moments before the show. It now appears 17-year-old Danielle Medina, now the babysitter, apparently moved from New York about 2 to 3 months ago, but just moved into this house on Friday night. So she started to babysit Saturday. Apparently, she didn't babysit for all that long.
Clark Golban, it's my understanding the mom got the babysitter through an acquaintance. That's how I have my babysitter, through an acquaintance that I trusted. Where'd this babysitter come from?
Exactly right, Nancy. There are some reports out there that she obtained the babysitter through an acquaintance. We believe it is a friend of the family.
Joining me right now is special guest, Police Chief Stephen Shelby. Chief Shelby, thank you for being with us. Chief, tell me, where was the mother when the babysitter and the baby vanished?
What she's telling us is that her and her mother went to East St. Louis to pick some clothes up for the baby.
Everyone, you are seeing a shot right now of babysitter Danielle Medina. When mommy gets home from getting the baby clothes, babysitter and baby gone. Chief, again, thank you for being with us, Chief Shelby. What can you tell us about the babysitter secretly wanting a baby of her own? Did she tell people she wanted her own baby?
Through our investigations, Ms. Grace, we learned that she has been making those statements. I haven't heard it myself. Some of the officers have, but I can't substantiate that. But we have heard the same rumors, yes.
Chief, if she's only got no cell phone, I doubt she's got a lot of money. She'd only been working there a couple of days. How is she traveling?
She's using public transportation, and that, again, that is a big concern for us. We're concerned for the baby's health and well-being. I mean, the weather down here is not very good. It's raining. It's thunderstorm. There's lightning. She's got a diaper bag. She's got a stroller, maybe 2 diapers in there. She has no money, so that is a big concern for us.
This little baby, 5-month-old Cortez Rose, is in severe danger. Back to you, Clark Golban. What can you tell me about this babysitter telling people she wanted her own baby?
Yes, Nancy, there was a report that surfaced a few hours ago that says, in fact, that the child, according to the mom, the sitter, according to the mom, has been saying, I want my own child, and was in fact telling people she was pregnant.
Was she pregnant?
Not that we know of.
Okay. Problems. Out to the lines, Debbie, California. Hi, Debbie.
Hi. Thank you for taking my call.
Thank you for calling in, dear. What's your question?
Yes, I just wondered if they had traced any convictions on her for babies, doing anything before this.
Well, as a matter of fact, Debbie, you're dead on. Clark.
Yes, Nancy. She's been convicted in New York of child endangerment. Now, it's our understanding, according to reports, there are also outstanding warrants on her for robbery.
And, you know, this is what's so crazy. Let's go out to Eleanor Dixon. Her specialty as a felony prosecutor is crimes on women and children. Joining us out of the Atlanta jurisdiction. Eleanor, when you get a reference for a babysitter through an acquaintance, you don't think to run their rap sheet. And frankly, most civilians don't know how to go about getting a rap sheet if it dawned on them they needed one.
You're exactly right, Nancy. And this mother herself was only 16 years old, a teenager. She certainly wouldn't have the resources to do that. I mean, it's not like she's sitting at home drinking martinis. She went out shopping, left her baby with somebody she thought she could trust.
Out to the defense attorneys, Peter Odom, Atlanta jurisdiction, Hugo Rodriguez out of Miami. This babysitter's in a whole lot of trouble, Odom.
She is, Nancy. Under Illinois law, she could face 37 years if that baby's not returned in good health.
And even if the baby is returned in good health, Hugo Rodriguez, it's felony kidnapping of a minor, a five-month-old baby. You know, when I had the twins, I wouldn't even take them out to a restaurant. They went nowhere for many, many months after they came home from the hospital. At best, this baby's out on public transportation, according to Chief Shelby.
If Danielle Medina or anyone...
The swine flu, for Pete's sake. People are dropping in New York like flies.
Nancy, if anyone is close to Miss Medina, knows where she's at, or has any contact with her, what they should advise her to do is contact a lawyer immediately, whether in Illinois or somewhere else, so that we could arrange for the return of that child. We'll deal with the other things later.
5 months old, this newborn is missing. Tip line, 618-876-4300.